Hi, today we will see this large device. I got this stuff from RR auctions in USA a few months ago. It was estimated $200, but I got it for a little bit more than $300. Including various taxes and shipment to France, the total cost was approximately €600 for this stuff. This stuff is a Gyro reference unit, which was designed for an Atlas launcher. You can see here the label from RR auction. Well, there are two identical gyros. We can see one here on the top. There is another one on the bottom side, which is orthogonally placed. Okay, it is exactly the same here. And there are also two modules. One here. Okay, so we can see first this sticker, which is the identification of that device. Okay, so it is called Attitude Reference Subsystem, model GR10A-1. So there are some information regarding the power supply of that thing. There is on that side a connector, a circular connector. Okay, and there is a second potted module, so it will be very difficult to see what is inside. Okay, so there is something written here on that side here, so it is written exactly. So this is the U demodulator. I don't know exactly what is the purpose of these two demodulators. One for the yaw and second one for the roll or pitch, I don't know. The second one is for the roll. Okay, so we have one roll demodulator and one yaw demodulator. Okay, so what we can do first is to remove one gyro. And I will try to take it apart. There is also a circular connector here. Okay, you can hear a very strange noise. So it seems that this thing is full of oil. Okay, I will try to remove this cover. Well, it is complicated to remove this cover. So here, this cover is in aluminium, but there is a metallic ring here. And aluminium again. I don't know what to do. Actually, I think I will cut here with a saw in order to see if I can remove also this cover. Okay, so I cut this cover all around here. Well, this method is a little bit brutal, medieval, but at least it will be possible to see something from that side. Okay, you can see on that side there is a kind of large screw here. Well, this is maybe used to fill that thing with oil. So there is here a metallic stuff. So this is made with iron. You can see the magnet here. But the body is in aluminium. So I think after removing the remaining of the cover, it should be possible to remove the complete stuff here, which permits to have a seal of the internal. We can see a capacitor here. This capacitor is probably used for the AC motor, for the rotor of the gyro. Okay, we can see that there are several screws here. So I will try to remove these screws, so I hope it will be possible to remove the complete assembly. Okay, so I will try to remove this plate. I don't know if it is a good idea, but we can see that there are some brush contacts in the center here. Okay, so let's try. Okay, so the brush contacts are removed on that side. But there is something which is stuck here. I think this is these two wires here, which are soldered also. Probably these two wires here. As you can see, I have desoldered these two wires here. Okay, so now, effectively, it's better. Oops. This was a very bad idea. Okay, so this is a gyro. Okay, so we can see that there is a synchro on each axis, one here and another one here. Okay, so we can see here two things. So one is the second part of the synchro, this is this part here, and this coil is actually a torque motor. So this is the rotor of the torque motor, so this is actually a short circuit. Okay. The torque is generated using eddy current. Okay, on this rotor here. So the torque is applied on that axis here. Okay, so this permits to change actually the position of the internal gimbal here. And we should have another one inside for the second axis. Okay, the problem will be to reinsert the shaft here with a very tiny contacts. I hope I didn't destroy the contacts. The problem is that they are not accessible, they are in the middle of that stuff.